Welcome back guys to another one, and today I'm going to show you some really cool and useful gadgets from Silverstone that are meant to take your NVMe storage solutions to a whole new level. The industrial standard for connectors and protocols, known as the Universal Serial Bus USB, was designed to standardize the connection of peripherals to personal computers, both to communicate with and to supply electric power. Since the demand for faster and faster ways to communicate, the nomenclature has gotten way out of hand lately. For example, we have USB 3.1 Gen 2, which has the same bandwidth, 10 GB per second, as the USB 3.2 Gen 2 and 3.2 Gen 1 X2. Alas, here is a simplification. However, USB 4 is in the works to proceed to the next step and simplify the naming scheme, but until then the USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 is the fastest we have currently, which has a max theoretical bandwidth of 20 GB per second, since it uses two lanes of 10 GB per second to achieve this double throughput. Then, not long ago, for an external enclosure storage device to even approach 10 GB per second was unheard of, but finally we have a full solution thanks to companies like Silverstone. More specifically, a fast USB-based external storage solution was much needed, especially with the advancements in the NVMe M.2 SSD sector. Today we're having a look at the MS-12, which is a USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 20 GB per second capable Type-C enclosure for most Gen 3 X4 NVMe SSDs, where you can install your desired drive, either a single or double-sided one. The cherry on top is the extra cooling it offers, and thus it should prevent any thermal throttling. Then you might ask what happens if I don't have a USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 capable port on an older system. This is where the second item from our video comes into play, the ECU06 PCIe adapter card, because it will solve just that. As mentioned before, the ability to have an NVMe drive as an external cable device is epic in itself, thus the pricing shouldn't surprise anybody considering that this will actually cool and prevent any thermal throttling, because we all know how hot NVMe M.2s usually get. As for the adapter card, it also adheres to the same principle. To get access to these high-speed protocols, you must pay to play. Especially that motherboards with native USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 are a thing only with the Intel Z490 chipsets and above. Both products follow the same overall theme of blue and white, with a visual depiction of the actual items. The 20GB SuperSpeed Plus protocol is highly visible, since it's the name of the game here. On the back we have the spec lists, with the added bonus for the MS-12, which has a thermal imaging example of how cool it keeps a popular and hot NVMe drive, in this case a Samsung 960 Pro. Inside you get the following: one grey thermal pad which is 2mm thick for a single-sided M.2, then one blue thermal pad at 1mm thick for double-sided M.2s, a warranty card, a 30cm long Type-C to Type-C USB cable, some spare Allen bolts and an Allen screwdriver. Regarding the adapter card, you only get a low profile metal adapter, which is highly welcomed since you can install this one in low profile cases or like OEM builds, for example. Zooming in, the ECU06 uses an ASMedia ASM3242 controller, thus it bridges the PCIe to USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 to offer the high bandwidth of 20 GB per second, also marked on the PCB under the board's revision. Now let's focus on the MS-12 NVMe external enclosure. It has this simple and industrial look, which comes mostly from the full aluminium body and its cooling fins. Overall, the enclosure is designed to work as a heat conductor. Each side has four screws that hold into place the top plates. This is such a cool example where form follows function. Even the sides have a cooling pattern to them. The fit and finish is excellent, as you can probably tell from the footage. On this side, here is where you'll connect the included or any Type-C USB cable. Then that little hole next to the USB port is the activity LED. It's very easy to access the internal PCB where you will install your desired M.2, just by removing the four screws on each side with the help of the included screwdriver. As you can see, both cover plates have their own thermal pads already pre-installed. So on this side we see the second generation USB 3.2 ASMedia ASM2364 controller, which is compliant with the PCI Express Base Specification Revision 3.1 and NVMe Express Base Specification Revision 1.3C. On the other side is where you will install your NVMe M.2 SSD, which can be either a 42, 60 or 80mm long M.2. Since my testing silicon power A60 NVMe drive is a single-sided one, we need to install the thick gray thermal pad between the SSD and the green PCB. Also, the included Type-C cable has a very strong and healthy click when you connect it. When plugged in the computer, the MS-12 will have the blue LED on, and when you use the drive, it will start to blink. As for the ECU06 card, when installed, it will have a blue LED on, but when you connect the device to it, it will turn its color to red. My testing build has an ASUS Strix X370F motherboard, and its fastest port is a 10 GB per second one, which is under the old naming scheme of USB 3.1 Gen 2. After this, I will test also the MS-12 plugged into the adapter card. So, as we know, the USB 3.1 Gen 2 tops at 10 GB per second, and since the testing silicon power 860 NVMe drive is rated up to 2200 MB per second reads and 1600 MB per second writes, we see that the MS-12 is offering almost the full bandwidth that the motherboard supports. However, when we connect the MS-12 with the A60 inside to the ECU06 card, we see almost a 100% increase, thus doubling the performance. This alone proves that the MS-12 and the ECU06 work as advertised. Then what we saw in HDTune Pro is basically replicated here as well for both the read-writes test and for the remaining of the synthetic benchmarks. Then the burst speed test revolves around the quick copy transfer of 7 GB ISO installation file from the A60 drive onto itself. There is a bump in performance with the ECU06 card, but here it will mostly come down to the NVMe drive itself, since in the synthetics we saw that there is no bottleneck with neither the enclosure nor the card. Now let's inspect the operating temps. This is a tricky one, since you can't read the smart info fully when the drive is in the MS-12 or most M.2 external enclosures for that matter. The only way is with a thermal gun, which I don't have, but I borrowed the laser one and at least we have some numbers. So the Silicon Power A60 M.2 when installed in the testing PC with an ambient of 21 degrees and minimal airflow inside the case, it reached 72 degrees Celsius when benchmarking via Crystal Dismark. When the same A60 was inside the MS-12 external enclosure in the same test, I recorded on the surface of the heatsink around 59 degrees Celsius. So the MS-12 really works when it comes to an effective heat dissipation by lowering the temperature by around 13 degrees Celsius. Mind you, this was recorded on the surface of the heatsink, so take a few degrees for margin of error for the actual inside temp, but nonetheless it's cooler overall. Well, there you have it guys, Silverstone has done a great job here with the MS-12 since it delivers on what it promises to keep an NVMe drive cool while offering as close as it can to the 20 GB per second bandwidth. The build quality is excellent and the enclosure comes with everything you need to install your desired single or double-sided M.2. Even if you don't have a free USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 port to access the maximum theoretical throughput, it's still backwards compatible and the overall performance will boil down to what drive you install. When combined with the ECU06 card, as you saw, you are virtually guaranteed to enjoy the total available speed. Regarding the adapter card, plain and simple, it's the only way to access the fastest USB protocol of 3.2 Gen 2 X2, 20 GB per second super speed plus, at the moment without owning an expensive motherboard. It's a plug and play upgrade that works as advertised and only requires at least one PCI 3.0 X4 slot on your motherboard. So, thank you for watching guys, and see you in the next one. Alex out.